In the previous lesson, we showed how an Earth's gravitational field decreases beneath Earth's surface, and how at Earth's center, the field is zero. Now let's consider a tunnel bored completely through Earth, say from the North Pole to the South Pole, so rotational effects are minimum. If you fell into such a tunnel through Earth, what would be your fate? Would you fall to the center and then stop, because the force of gravity at the center and Earth's field there is zero? No way, for you'd have considerable momentum, right? Or would you shoot out the other side like a cannonball? No way. Where would this additional energy come from? In the interest of time, I'll just tell you what would happen, if you don't already know. If we pretend that Earth has a uniform density, you'd speed up in your fall toward the center at a uniformly decreasing acceleration and whiz past the center at maximum speed. Then you'd continue up the other side. How far? To your initial height, but at the opposite end of the tunnel. And if you didn't grab onto the surface, you'd fall back and continue your motion to and fro. You'd oscillate in what we call simple harmonic motion. And the time for a round trip would be about 90 minutes. Quite remarkably, an Earth satellite, shown here in purple, in close circular orbit, also takes the same time, about 90 minutes, for a complete single orbit. Is this a coincidence? The answer is no. For as it happens, a satellite and you oscillating in the tunnel would move to the same rhythm and keep up with each other. In fact, your simple harmonic motion is a projection of uniform motion in a circle. You and the satellite have the same period of motion. You both make your trips in the same time. Let's look at this in detail. Here's a dashed reference line. Let's raise it a bit so it lines up with the satellite. And pretend you begin your fall where the satellite is. Now, you fall to the one-quarter point down the tunnel. Here's the bit. During your falling time, the satellite progresses to here. Note the reference line, a match. And during the time you reach the halfway point, the satellite progresses to here. One-quarter its way to making a full circle, as seen by the reference line. And during the time it takes you to reach the three-quarter point, the satellite moves to here. Again, the reference line coincides with both you and the satellite. And in the time it takes you to reach the end of tunnel, guess what's there? That's right, the satellite. Another reference line match. And not surprisingly, the process repeats itself as you fall in the opposite direction to your starting point. And here's you making three cycles in simple harmonic motion. And here's the satellite making three orbital paths. Can you imagine these occurring simultaneously? Let's look at a three-quarter view of the satellite orbiting Earth. You wouldn't be able to see the satellite on the other side, which I'm showing here darkened. You can imagine you falling in simple harmonic motion all the while, right? Aha! If we look at the satellite motion not in a three-quarter view, but end-on, we see both you and the satellite in yum harmony. My artwork is crude compared with what an animation studio would do with this idea, but I'm hoping your imagination puts all this together and the concept is clear to you. All this is indeed fascinating, yes? Or we should say, yum-yum. Let me leave you with a question. When you whiz past the center of the tunnel through Earth with maximum speed, how does this speed compare with the constant speed of the satellite in close circular orbit? Think about that. Until next time, good energy.